be a singer. Since I was a little girl, since I could talk, I would practice with the ketchup bottle as my microphone, and I would sing to whatever, whoever would listen, whether it's the Potts who's there, the salt and pepper shakers, whatever. I would just sing. Well, and I've been doing it for a long time, and I've always known I wanted to do it.
And the Grammy goes to...
And the winner is...
Toni Braxton.
Toni Braxton!
PK is a preacher's kid, so of course it means I grew up singing in church all the time, and my sisters and I had a singing group. We were called the Braxton Sisters. So we would sing in church, and my mom is an amateur opera singer, so she taught me like the theory, and I guess singing in church was like practicum. So that's kind of how I started singing.
When she sings a song, that song truly becomes her song, and not just like this writer's idea of what Toni should do.
And Toni just has a certain quality about, not only in her, the way she sings, but she has a certain quality about her voice. She's just a very, very loved person around here.
I met L.A. and Faith in 1989. Actually, what happened, my sisters and I were on Arista Records, and we had a single out in 88. It was a big hit, and when Zinc and Copper, we were really excited about that. No, I'm joking. Actually, it was a flop, but it got the attention of L.A. and Faith, and some of the artists were going from Arista to LaFace, like Jermaine Jackson, for example. And my sisters and I did a showcase for them, and that's how they became aware of us, of me. I hate to say that, but that's how it happened.
It really took a lot of talking and a lot of encouragement on our part to really get her to consider being a solo performer.
Boomerang was what introduced me to radio. I was really fortunate because that song was originally for Anita Baker. Both songs, a duet with Faith and Love Should Have Brought You Home, but she turned it down. She was pregnant. And so it was a blessing for me.
When I first heard the song, I thought, oh, that is a beautiful song, because it really is a beautiful song.
Thanks.
And I said, and it sounds like Toni Braxton. And I was really happy to discover that it was you, because that means to me that you really do have a distinctive sound. You don't have to worry.
Thanks.
Yeah.
But even if they said Anita Baker, who cares? I mean, look, she's a wonderful singer.
Really?
That's okay.
True. That's
it's
true.
Okay.
But you're creating your own little niche.
Thanks. Another sad love song to me is a takeoff of Love Should Have Brought You Home, because after he didn't come home the night before, and you kick him out, you turn on the radio, what do you hear? Another sad love song.
If you just tuned in, this is my guest, Toni Braxton, one of the talented young ladies to hit the scene with her debut album, Toni Braxton, self-entitled.
Thank you.
It's me, Mommy, Mommy, it's me.
Oh, wrong.
Check it out. You sing all these wonderful songs about love. I mean, they seem like to come from a personal type thing, you know, like Love Should Have Brought You Home.
Right.
And another sad love song. What's your inspiration for these great hits?
I wanted to show that there were various sides of love. Love isn't always, oh, darling, hold me,
please.
Love isn't always like,
right.
You know that.
Yeah, that's
fine. You know, love involves things like Love Should Have Brought You Home. It involves thorns. It isn't always up all the time. This is a song on the album. It's a true story. It happened to me. My best friend, my boyfriend got together. Wrote a song about it. Like to hear it? Here you go. Oh, no, there's no way to begin or start love over. Oh, no, love making, will there be here tonight? Oh, 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 don't be sad or come crying on my shoulder. Should have thought about the consequences. You and my best friend. Breathe Again was truly the hardest video I've ever done because of the costuming.
Oh, because
the costumes are so heavy, and you know, and I was gonna wear a big wig, 17th century wig, but I'm so little. 110 pounds, a wig would have been heavier than that. Thank you. Seven Whole Days. That song is like a story for women all over the world. Because as a woman, you know, sometimes I'll go out and I meet a guy and, you know, we'll talk on the phone a few nights, whatever, but then he won't call me for a whole week. And that's entirely too long. I could say 2 days, 3 days, but 7 days? So it's kind of like, you know, I wanted all the other women across the world to know, hey, look, I've experienced these things too, and I want to sing about these issues. And when Elaine Trace wrote the song, it was like, okay, let's write about something that women claim they feel. You know, so I was happy to get the opportunity to sing the song.
It's my pleasure to introduce to you this evening a young lady who's been nominated for 2 Grammy Awards. All right. The lovely, the vivacious Miss Toni Braxton.
Thank you. Right. You know, I bet if I look up Mac Daddy in the dictionary, your picture is right next to it. And the definition would read good looking, suave, distinguished, charming, and witty.
Yeah, I'm all that. And a pension check, too. Come on, y'all, let's give it up for Miss Toni.
What I want to accomplish in my career is just to be an entertainer. Period. Whether it's singing, acting, anything, the whole picture of an entertainer.
一人で帰ってきたんじゃありません。私の心の恋人、ご紹介しましょう。スペシャルゲストです。トニー・ブラクソン。
Being heard all over the world is something very important to me. I sing about things that everyone can identify, and it's a shame just to share it with America. I want to share it with everyone. My goals.Just whatever I do in life, just to be great at it or do my best. I could sell 2 million records, and that would be, or one record, but as long as I have the best possible material that I can have for my fans and for my listeners and for radio, who've been so supportive of me, and I really appreciate it so much. That's what really matters right now. I'm just going to take it one day at a time, and definitely count my blessings.